You're damned if you do, and you're damned if you don't. So you might as well do. And we're going to talk about it when we get back. I'm CLM2 for Style with Power, the channel that helps empower men through style.
Okay.
Happy Monday and happy Labor Day. And for those of you out there who don't know what Labor Day is, that is the day that we celebrate all of the people who have done the hard work for this country and made sure that this country keeps on moving, keeps on rolling. So they actually have an official day for laborers. And of course, if you work anywhere in the United States and you earn some money, today is your day off. Officially, it's Labor Day. Also, Labor Day is the official last day of summer. But because of the pandemic, summer is going to be extended. Yes, nothing is closing down for the summer until probably the end of September. Why we ended summer so early, I don't know. But now, because of the pandemic, we're going to officially end summer on the last day of summer, which is around the 22nd or something like that. Well, enough of that. Listen, if you're into videos that talks about style, that talks about fashion, that talks about empowerment, and that talks about mindset, well, you know what? This is a channel for you. And thank you for joining the channel. So, in order to help out the channel, help me out, I need you to go down and subscribe. Hit the little notification bell so that you'll know every time we upload a video. And if you see this video on Facebook, hit the like button. If you see it on Instagram, you know, just give a thumbs up and give a like. And of course, if you see it on YouTube, just go ahead and subscribe. You'll definitely help us out. So, what's today's topic about? You're damned if you do, and you're damned if you don't. So you might as well do. Well, you know what? I want to talk about a father. He looks like he's a great dad, you know, to his boys. He has four sons. Looks like he's a great dad. But he wrote an open letter to LeBron James saying that LeBron James doesn't speak for him and his boys. Very, very interesting that he would make this claim, being that LeBron James has been one of the most outstanding individuals out there fighting for social justice. You know, probably the most well-known individual, not only here in the United States, but around the world because of his prowess in the basketball world. Also, he does a lot of generous donations. He builds schools.
He is known as King James, and now some might be calling him LeBron the Headmaster. The basketball superstar opened an elementary school in his hometown with every single detail carefully designed to change students' lives. And it comes as James is speaking out about President Donald Trump, telling CNN the president is trying to use sports to divide the country.
In a new interview overnight, basketball star LeBron James criticizing President Trump.
We are in a position right now in America, more importantly, where this race thing is taking over, you know, because I believe our president is kind of trying to divide us. But I think...
Kinda?
Yeah, is. Not, I don't want to say kinda. He's dividing us, and what I noticed over the last few months, that he's kind of used sport to kind of divide. And sports has never been something that divide people. It's always been something that brings someone together.
President Trump has repeatedly slammed some professional athletes for refusing to visit the White House, as has been customary after championships, and others for kneeling during the national anthem to protest police brutality and racial injustice. The president's stance angering James, who doesn't hesitate when asked what he would say to President Trump if he was sitting across the table from him.
I would never sit across from him.
You would never? You don't want to talk to him?
No.
James using his powerful platform to speak up about racial issues and race relations. And after years of schooling some of the greatest players on the court, now he's schooling elementary kids in his hometown. In Akron, Ohio, a LeBron James promise kept and delivered. Here, gleaming halls filled with some of the world's most valuable sneakers worn over a career full of accolades. Nearly two decades ago, LeBron says he was a statistic, a kid who frequently missed class as he and his mom struggled to get by.
When I was a kid, I didn't have much, so I always told myself if I ever get anything, then I want to give back to, you know, some of the less fortunate.
Now, after signing a massive new contract with the LA Lakers, LeBron has made good on his word. In his new school named I Promise, 240 third and fourth graders identified as needing support chosen for the first classes, with plans to expand through eighth grade soon. Doing his part to unite his community through promises he's kept all his life.
No matter if I'm playing in Los Angeles or not, Akron, Ohio is always home for me. Always.
The man is doing some great things, and the man is a great role model. I mean, he has not been involved in any crazy controversy in his whole 17-year career. And I can truly say, you know, watching him play for all 17 years and watching him even in his private world, the young man has done an outstanding job. So why would this father say that LeBron James doesn't speak for him? Well, it's very, very complicated, and I have the story in the link down below. But basically he's saying that LeBron James is not a role model for him and his sons. I can understand that. Many of us who are old enough to remember when there was another gentleman who was a great basketball player, and he got into some controversy in the 90s, and he had to let the world know, I am not a role model. So, you know what? I'm gonna play the commercial that was done for him in the 90s because of that statement, and let's see if you recognize this young man.
I am not a role model. I'm not paid to be a role model. I am paid to wreak havoc on the basketball court. Parents should be role models. Just because I dunk a basketball doesn't mean I should raise your kids.
For those of you who do not recognize that young man, he is now an older man in his 50s, and that is the great Charles Barkley. And in the 90s, Charles got into some controversy where he actually was in a rough and tumble, you know, altercation with a fan in the stands at a basketball game. And allegedly he spit at the fan, and it was a big uproar. He got fined like $25,000. Because of that incident, he was vilified by individuals saying that, you know, Charles, you are a role model. Kids are looking up to you, and for you to act this way is just appalling. Well, Charles answered back by saying, I am no role model. Children should not be looking up to me. They should be looking up to their parents. And because of that, Nike, the big time shoe company, decided to do a commercial with Charles, which you just seen, saying, I am no role model, and that parents should be role models for their kids. Well, Charles, easier said than done. And because of that situation, studies were done where individuals went out and actually was, you know, did a study of young people and asking them how many of them had sports stars as their role model or who they look up to. And unfortunately, just because Charles said, I am no role model, it did not deter young people from still looking up to athletes. And even until this day, because that study has gone on since the 90s all the way up until now, it's been found that young people still look at athletes as role models. So whether athletes feel that they're not role models or not, guess what? You are role models. So, getting back to the original story, the father, who says LeBron James does not speak for him and his boys, unfortunately, sir, your boys will be looking up to probably someone like LeBron James or some other athlete, because as much as we as parents want our kids to look up to us and believe in us and tell us all their secrets, they just don't. And when we were kids, we didn't tell our parents all of our secrets, and we knew all types of things about our parents, and our parents sometimes were not role models for us. But what we would like is that we would like for our children, if they're going to look up to athletes as role models, to find ones who we believe represents the things that we want our children to learn. And there's no better role model than LeBron James. This young man has done nothing but good work since he has been in the league. So I say to this dad, I understand how you may feel. You may have some differences in the whole social justice movement. You may feel that, you know, that black people don't represent you, even though that you are black. You may feel that you're in a safe environment and that you have never dealt with racial controversy. But as they say, if one of us are going through oppression, all of us are going through oppression, because none of us are free until all of us are free. And it's so interesting, because after that Charles Barkley controversial commercial, Nike did another controversial commercial just 2 years ago in 2018 with a gentleman that you may know. So let's look at that commercial, and we'll be right back.
If people say your dreams are crazy, if they laugh at what you think you can do, good. Stay that way. Because what non-believers fail to understand is that calling a dream crazy is not an insult. It's a compliment. Don't try to be the fastest runner in your school or the fastest in the world. Be the fastest ever. Don't picture yourself wearing OBJ's jersey. Picture OBJ wearing yours. Don't settle for homecoming queen or linebacker. Do both. Lose 120 pounds and become an Ironman after beating a brain tumor. Don't believe you have to be like anybody to be somebody. If you're born a refugee, don't let it stop you from playing soccer for the national team at age 16. Don't become the best basketball player on the planet. Be bigger than basketball. Believe in something, even if it means sacrificing everything. When they talk about the greatest team in the history of the sport, make sure it's your team. If you have only one hand, don't just watch football, play it at the highest level. And if you're a girl from Compton, don't just become a tennis player. Become the greatest athlete ever. Yeah, that's more like it. So don't ask if your dreams are crazy. Ask if they're crazy enough.
Well, I guess everyone out there probably remembers that commercial from 2 years ago, and that was Colin Kaepernick's commercial that Nike did, and that was a controversial commercial also. And you know, because Colin Kaepernick was not looked upon very well by America at that time, because they felt that he was disrespecting the United States and the United States flag. But come to find out, Colin Kaepernick was just letting you all know that we as black people were not being treated well. And now, 2 years after his controversy in the National Football League, now everyone is taking a knee, and now the Black Lives Movement is moving greatly. Individuals like Colin Kaepernick, individuals like LeBron James, these are great role models. And I say to that father out there that you may want to rethink what you're saying, because unfortunately, you won't be there to protect your boys. So the only thing that I hope for that father is that he teaches his boys that because of the color of their skin, they may be discriminated against. And the last thing that I'll say is that Nike, the owner of Nike, is a gentleman by the name of Phil Knight. And Phil Knight was worried about doing the Colin Kaepernick commercial because he thought he was going to get the wrath of all the people if he did that commercial with Colin Kaepernick. But the reason why he did the commercial is because he had a conversation with one LeBron James. And they both were talking about their children who are now graduating from high school and going off to college. And Phil Knight was saying how he's so happy, but he's a little afraid because his child will start to drive. And when, you know, high school students graduate, they get their driver's license and they start to drive. And Phil was saying that he's a little bit worried that his child is going to be driving. And LeBron James said to Phil Knight, "Well, I'm also afraid for my, you know, for my boys, because my son also is graduating and he's also going to be driving. But I'm afraid that when my son is 17, 18 years of age and he's driving in a fancy car, he may get shot or hurt by the police." And that conversation stuck with Phil Knight. And that's why Phil Knight said, "I have to make this Colin Kaepernick commercial." See, we have to have those conversations with our children, especially our boys. But Phil Knight says that conversation never, ever, ever entered his mind that he would have to tell his children to watch out for the police. That's the difference. So I say to that father out there, I'm hoping that you're having those courageous conversations with your boys. And if LeBron James is not the type of guy who you want to speak for you or your boys, I don't know who is. Well, the last thing that we're going to talk about is a big congratulations to one of our own great, talented individuals out there who just hit a milestone this year. It was announced by Forbes magazine that our very own Tyler Perry is now officially a billionaire. Congratulations, Tyler. You deserve everything that you have. Tyler Perry is another individual who, you know, we would probably love to call a role model. This gentleman has built his empire from the ground up, had some controversy in his life when he was younger, fought through it, stuck it out, used his talents to build an empire where he now has his own studio down in Atlanta. He creates and owns all of his works on television and in the movies. He's just done some fantastic things, and now he's officially a billionaire, and he's helped countless amount of people. He is so generous. You just have to say to this guy, congratulations, you deserve it, and we wish nothing but the best for Tyler Perry. Well, there you have it. That's our show for this week. And I will see you next week.